Mark Scott, the ABC today has launched Australia's first free-to-air 24-hour television news channel. What can people expect to see?
Well, they're going to see the best of the ABC's journalism. We've got more reporters locally, nationally and internationally than anyone else in the Australian media. And that work of those reporters will provide the foundation for the news channel, which will be available free of charge on digital television in every Australian home.
And what's it going to be called?
We don't know that yet. We're still working on that. And there'll be some programming details that we'll be announcing down the track as well. But we needed to make this announcement today because we're building a new studio at the ABC headquarters in Ultimo, which will be in the foyer. So people will be able to see the news channel coming to life each day. We're going to be recruiting later on this month for more journalists to come and work at the ABC to staff the news channel. So we needed to make it clear that the channel is coming. It'll be on air in 2010 and it will be made available on free-to-air television.
ABC4 has been suggested as a name. Will you take that on board?
Can't confirm any names. Of course, we've now got 1, 2 and 3. We're delighted with how ABC3 is going since its launch in December. But we've long had ambitions for a news channel. This makes sense for the ABC because of our investment in journalism, the fact that we've had this wonderful reputation for delivering Australians the news for the best part of 75 years. And now's the time because our audience wants to be able to turn on the television and see what's happening from Australia and around the world at any time of the day or night. We need to deliver the service that Australians want and we need to deliver it for them where they want it on free-to-air television.
When can they turn this channel on?
Well, it'll definitely be in 2010. We've got teams of people who'll be working on it now. We have ambitions for the middle of the year, but it just depends on a few things falling into place. There's an election expected later in 2010. We'd love to be on air for that. It depends a little bit if the government runs full term, but we'll be working round the clock to deliver our round the clock news channel.
Now, there's no new government funding for this channel. How has it been made possible? How much is it going to cost?
We're not revealing the detailed budget figures, and we don't provide detailed budgetary breakdowns for our different divisions, but we've made some significant savings in recent years, moving to new production models for news and television, and we made those savings anticipating that we would need to be able to fund a news channel if that's what we decided we wanted to do. So we've made the savings, which will allow us to build the studios, recruit the new staff, and make it operational. So we're seeking no additional government funding for the news channel at this point. We'll be getting it on air with the funding that the taxpayers always give us, and that funding does provide the best resourced news broadcasting operation in the country.
Will it affect what you can do, given that there will be no new funding? You're saying that the money we have at the moment is from savings.
Well, we clearly won't have an unlimited budget. Clearly, we'll have to taper the channel to the budget that we have, but that's the same as every media organisation in the world. We will not be impinging on our commitment to our current quality programs. Our focus on delivering, you know, the 7 o'clock news, 7:30 report, Four Corners, Late Line, Insiders, that all absolutely remains intact. But we do have additional money which allows us to go and build new studios, get the technology that we need, and also to recruit the staff that we need who'll be working on the channel every day.
So given it's a 24-hour news channel, you've just talked about Late Line, 7pm News, those programs will remain, there won't be a change?
Yeah, absolutely. They remain on ABC One. This is a digital TV channel. Not everyone can get digital TV at the moment, and it will only be in 2013 when digital television is completely rolled out around the country and everybody has it. And in the first instance, we'll be delivering this on the high-definition spectrum that we have. We've been given no additional spectrum to deliver this channel, so it'll be delivered on the HD spectrum at first instance. But the 7 o'clock news will still be on ABC One, as will Four Corners, as will Late Line, as will our suite of current programs. But if people are wanting continuous coverage of the major news events that are taking place in Australia and around the world, they'll be able to go to the new news channel. And we'll also give us some opportunity to replay some of those landmark programs that we put to air on ABC One, and we'll be able to replay them on the news channel also.
Do you expect there to be new programs as well as rerunning other programs, breaking news?
There certainly will be new programs, and we'll be announcing the schedule of those a little bit later on in the year. I mean, we've been preparing for this for a while, and ABC News Breakfast on ABC 2 has been an important pilot program for us so that we can develop the capability of doing quality news, ABC News, live and continuous. And I think if people want an expectation of what the channel might be like, the ABC News Breakfast program gives a good indication of how we tap into all the ABC resources, locally, nationally and internationally, to deliver a quality service that's quite distinctive but very ABC.
You're obviously well aware of the criticisms of public broadcasting by James Murdoch and indeed his father Rupert Murdoch about public broadcasting and its expansion and whether that's a good idea. Is the ABC up to it?
The ABC is absolutely up to it, and the ABC has a charter, and our charter is to be an innovative broadcaster, a comprehensive broadcaster, and to inform the nation. Now, we started off in radio with radio news, then we moved to television when the audience moved to television. Now in this digital era where audiences want news 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, they want to be able to access it at the time they want, that's obvious space for us to fill. And we're moving into 24-hour news because we have the expertise, we have the reputation, we deliver the quality, people trust us. And so we're the ideal people to deliver this service. None of the commercial free-to-air broadcasters have looked to create a 24-hour news channel. We're obviously the news leaders on free-to-air television, so this is an obvious space for us to fill.
To what extent do you think the ABC risks, I guess, dumbing down its program, sacrificing quality for quantity to pump it out for this new channel?
No, I don't think it's a case of dumbing down at all. I think what it's really to do with is to deliver the quality and the service that the audience expects. And the audience expects from the ABC journalism of quality, journalism of independence, journalism of integrity. That's why they come to us. That's why they trust us. That's what we're delivering on the new news channel.
And how then do we avoid the repetition of what you see on CNN and BBC, where you see a lot of the same stuff over and over and over?
Yeah. I think one of the things about a news channel is that people will often come into it for a relatively short period of time and duck out again. And so stories are repeated on 24-hour news channels around the world. I think we are fortunate, though, because we do have the great investment we already have in newsrooms around the country. 8 newsrooms, a major newsroom in every state and territory capital, newsrooms linked in with our local radio sites, 60 local radio sites around the country, and 12 international bureaus. So we have a lot of investment already that in journalists who are developing different stories, which we'll be able to draw on, which will provide the underpinning for the news channel.
There's obviously already a lot of pressure on those journalists in newsrooms in Australia and obviously around the world. At the moment, we're in the midst of the Haiti earthquake coverage. Will there be more expectation, more pressure on those journalists to also be, I guess, filing for the news channel as well?
I think the journalists are doing this anyway now. I think we've moved to an era in recent years where there's not just an expectation around 7 o'clock, but we're delivering updated news bulletins online. Most of our journalists are working for television and radio and online. And so it's really a continuation of that. And it's really taking advantage of the content that journalists are producing already rather than putting pressure on them to deliver more. But I think Haiti is a great example. I mean, alone really of Australian media outlets, the ABC has 3 media crews on the ground in Haiti now doing outstanding work covering that horrendous story and making it real for Australians who are watching. We've made the investment in covering that story. That comes through the quality of the work that we are putting to air, and that's the quality of work that people will see on the new ABC News channel.
I guess finally, obviously, the spectrum is there, the availability is there. Do you think that viewers want another news channel? If people are happy with what they get online from ABC Radio, from the 7 p.m. news, are they going to be consuming a news channel as well?
Look, I think many will. And a news channel is never the kind of programming that tops the ratings. We're not looking to top the ratings. We're looking to just deliver a quality service to Australians. And I think it's terrific for those Australians who've chosen to stick with free-to-air television, that now on free-to-air television in Australia, you don't just have the channels that have been there for a long period of time, but you've got a sports channel that's been offered by one of the commercial networks, you've got a children's channel that's being offered by the ABC, you're going to get a news channel as well. So for those audience members who want it, or when a major story breaks, they just know they need to tune on the set and the ABC will be there delivering.
Mark Scott, thank you.
Thank you.